Citizens speak out. The calls for dignity and democracy continue to grow as people peacefully gather and join in marches to demand government reforms in nations that include Bahrain, Egypt, Jordan, Libya, Malaysia, Palestine, Syria, and Yemen.
Egypt's Interior Ministry announced it has created a new department to communicate with human rights and civil society groups as part of an effort for the police to regain credibility by ensuring that citizens are treated with respect. Thousands of Egyptians also rallied on Friday, May 20th, calling for former President Hosni Mubarak and others in his government to be held accountable for their actions in courts of law.
U.S. President Barack Obama received international commendations for the Middle East policy he outlined on Thursday, which included Arab-Israeli peace to be gained through the creation of an independent Palestinian state based on Israel's pre-1967 borders, although Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, who met with President Obama on Friday, said that such a move would be indefensible. Other dignitaries joining in support included Israel's Kadima party leader, Zippy Livni, German Chancellor Angela Merkel, German Foreign Minister Guido Westerwelle, French Foreign Minister Alain Juppé, Polish Foreign Minister Radoslaw Sikorski, British Foreign Secretary William Hague, Swedish Foreign Minister Carl Bildt, European Union Foreign Policy Chief Catherine Ashton, Australian Foreign Minister Kevin Rudd, Egypt's UN Ambassador Maged Abdelaziz, and the diplomatic quartet on the Middle East, comprising the European Union, United Nations, and Russia and Jordan.
Meanwhile, two Palestinian protesters were wounded on Friday and one was killed Saturday by Israeli soldiers during protest marches in Gaza, with an Israeli spokesperson saying they were shot when they came too close to the border fence.
Thousands of Jordanians marched in continued weekly protests calling for reforms that include an end to corruption and the removal of certain government officials.
In Syria, following Friday prayers, clashes during large rallies in multiple cities such as Homs, Daraz, Latakia, Idlib, and Deir ez-Zor resulted in at least 34 protester fatalities. Boys of ages 10 and 11 were among those reported killed, with an estimated 4,000 who have now fled to Lebanon to escape the violence in their homeland, some of whom have been detained by Lebanese officials. The UN High Commissioner for Refugees announced plans to help the Syrian refugees.
Hundreds of Bahrainis marched on Friday, calling for all those detained by the government in the crackdown on protests to be immediately released, as Saudi citizens marched in solidarity, saying that their government's troops should be withdrawn from Bahrain, while also calling for the release of fellow Saudis held in long-term detention without charge.
The U.S. military announced Friday that it would send non-lethal aid to Libyan revolutionaries, including tents and protective vests. After weeks of uncertainty about the fate of South African photojournalist Anton Hamerl, it was confirmed that he had been fatally shot by Libyan forces.
With sorrow for the loss of precious lives, we pray that the conflicts may end, with growing peace emerging as people of all nations choose the dignity and the freedom of harmonious lives.